Hey guys, welcome to Mama's Voice. In this program, we will meet priests from around the globe. We will discuss interesting features of their lives, from their humble beginnings, their calling, the churches, and more.
Sa pagpapatuloy ng ating vegan series, makakasama natin sa episode na ito ang lubhang kagalang-galang Marlo Peralta, ang arsobispo ng Nueva Segovia. Pakinggan ang kanyang vocation story. Dito lang lahat yan sa Mama's Voice, Mama Mary's Voice.
Hello po, Archbishop. Welcome po sa aming programa na Mama's Voice, Mama Mary's Voice po. Archbishop, maraming salamat po sa pagpapaunlak niyo po sa amin sa interview ito.
Ay, maraming salamat din sa inyo dahil pagkakataon ito na at least ma-reach out kung sino-sino na they will benefit from this interview.
Okay. Archbishop, una po sa lahat, can you share a little something about yourself po sa ating po mga viewers?
Well, ako ay taga Pangasinan. Taga Pangasinan ako, doon ako lumaki. I was born 1950, so as you know, matanda na. And then, doon na rin ako pumasok sa seminary, minor. At saka yung theology, dito na ako sa Bigan, sa Immaculate Conception School of Theology. So, I was ordained 1975. Siyempre, bumalik ako sa Pangasinan. Doon ako nagkaroon ng iba't ibang assignment sa parokya, mostly parokya. And then, I was made bishop in 2006. So, yung first assignment ko as bilang bishop ay sa Alaminos. So, I stayed there for 7 years. And then, nalipat ako dito sa Bigan, Archdiocese of Nueva Segovia since dumating ako 2014 hanggang ngayon. So, 9 years na ako dito.
Yes po.
So, yun lang so far.
Ano po yan, Archbishop? Paano po kayo napasok into the priesthood? Pangarap niyo po ba ito?
Hindi, actually, usually kung bata ka, you have an inspiration, ano, tulad ng, so I have an uncle who is a priest. So, siya yung nag-encourage sa akin. Well, I was still elementary years. So, doon pumasok ako sa seminary. At siguro doon na ako nagkaroon ng vocation. Nag-grow na yung vocation ko doon. Sa loob ng seminary hanggang dito na.
Pero wala po kayo, hindi po kayo nag-took up ng course? I mean, hindi po kayo lumabas sa seminary?
Hindi.
Tuloy-tuloy po yun.
Tuloy-tuloy na yun. Kaya, kwan. May mga iba na they need to stay out for a while.
Yes po.
Pero sa akin, diretso na.
Eh, kahit regency po, hindi po kayo?
Hindi na. Sa panahon namin, walang regency kasi. Lumang panahon pa yun. Okay, so...
Archbishop, ano po yung inyong pinaka-memorable experience po as a priest?
As a priest, ano? Ewan kung what you mean by memorable, but para sa akin, memorable is how I live as a priest.
Yes po.
O, ganun yun. I tried my best to be faithful. To be faithful to God, to people, serving. Pero, pag any particular incident na tinatawag natin na memorable, I cannot remember one in particular. So, para sa akin, memorable is yung buhay mo as a priest, memorable na yun. Dahil tinutupad mo yung tungkulin mo bilang that itself is already memorable.
Yes po. Archbishop, sinabi niyo po kanina that you were inspired by your uncle po, who is a priest, ano po. If you don't mind me asking, ilang magkakapatid nga po kayo, Archbishop?
Dalawa lang kami.
Okay po.
Yes, because my father died very early. So, dalawa lang kami.
Yes po.
my mother did not remarry anymore.
Mm-hmm.
So she took care of us. My older sister is now in the US.
Mm-hmm.
Akong nandito ngayon. Mm-hmm. So yun, we are just two because my father died very early.
Yes po.
Baga siguro baka apat lima kami kung if he lived longer.
Mm-hmm. Pero Archbishop, ano po yung sinabi ng inyong mom nung sinabi niyo po or nagpaalam po kayo na gusto niyo pong pumasok into the religious life? Or...
Oh, wala naman. I think she was happy. She was mm-hmm. happy. Dinala ko sa seminary, high school pa noon.
Mm-hmm.
High school. And she was very supportive naman. Kasi we come from a Catholic family.
Yes po.
So, hindi naging problema ang pagpasok ko sa seminary.
Mm-hmm. May mga challenges po ba kayo na naranasan along the way po? Sa pagiging, ano po muna, seminarian and priest?
Again, I don't remember anything extraordinary na challenges. Siguro it's because yung daan, yun lang ang kwan. Yung pinagdaan, I just follow the path.
Mm-hmm.
So in a way, you could say that, well, indeed, that it doesn't mean you don't have problems.
Yes,
but nothing too big to disrupt your life naman as mm-hmm. a seminarian
mm-hmm.
or as a priest. Kasi problema naman, bahagi ng buhay yan.
Yes,
so,
pa.
Well, we all go through these things, but not in a way that will somehow detract you from what you want to do or your vocation as a priest.
Mm-hmm. Yan na po talaga, ano? Yung way mo.
Pero, not in a sense na perfect lahat. Hindi naman ganun.
Mm-hmm.
That's not what I mean. Okay? Mm-hmm.
How about po, nung bishop na po kayo or archbishop po, may mga challenges po sa iba't ibang dioceses?
Hindi. Yung sinasabi mong challenges are always there.
Yes,
no?
Po.
So, bilang obispo, ang isang challenge yan and na nararanasan ko and mm-hmm. I think every bishop is not everyone has the same perspective.
Mm-hmm.
You know? Iba't ibang opinions.
Mm-hmm. Individual differences.
Iba't ibang perspectives mm-hmm. sa anumang issue. So, that is a given.
Mm-hmm.
So, the challenge is how we can come together
yes.
and agree.
Magbabalik kami after a few reminders, kaya stay tuned, guys! Kayo pa rin ay nanonood ng Mama's Voice, Mama Mary's Voice. For more limang siglo content, like, share at subscribe natin ang ating mga social media platforms. Back on our interview with Archbishop Peralta.
How about po nung bishop na po kayo or archbishop po, may mga challenges po sa iba't ibang dioceses?
Hindi. Yung sinasabi mong challenges are always there.
Yes,
no?
Po.
So, bilang obispo, ang isang challenge yan and na nararanasan ko and mm-hmm. I think every bishop is not everyone has the same perspective.
Mm-hmm.
You know? Iba't ibang opinions.
Mm-hmm. Individual differences.
Iba't ibang perspectives mm-hmm. sa anumang issue. So, that is a given.
Mm.
So the challenge is how we can come together
yes.
and agree so that we can do this thing na may support ng marami. So usually ganyan ang challenge, how to bring things, people together
mm-hmm.
because of different yun nga, perspectives, opinions. What's important is,
mm-hmm.
Nakikinig na we try to be openness, nakikinig at saka dialogue.
Mm-hmm.
So pag may dialogue, something can always be achieved, although not 100%, but at least you can achieve something kung mm-hmm. may dialogue.
Mm-hmm. Last time po dito sa Vigan po, Archbishop, ay nagkaroon ng earthquake, ano po?
Yes.
And destructed some of the heritage churches here, yes, po. Pakikwento naman po, Archbishop, yung experience niyo po.
Yes, yes. So, when was the earthquake? It was quite strong. Hmm. It was quite strong. So, yung cathedral namin at saka ilang churches dito sa Archdiocese, they became unusable.
Mm-hmm.
So, nasara. Itong cathedral namin hanggang ngayon, nakasara pa. So, ito yung problema namin because people are asking when, for example, our cathedral will be restored,
yes,
so it can be used again. But it is NCCA who told us that they will take charge of the repair and the renovation. But it looks like it's going to take years.
Yes, po.
So, that's our dilemma now.
Mm-hmm.
So, and even the other churches that were affected, ganun din, ganun din. So, we are just praying and siguro we are working on things na mapadali sana ang repair ng aming cathedral.
Mm-hmm. Ano po, Archbishop, yung sinasabi niyo po sa mga tao, sa mga parishioners po, especially kapag lalo na po sila, Archbishop, namimiss na po namin, or Father, namimiss na po namin ang misa sa loob ng simbahan. Ano po usually yung sinasabi niyo po sa kanila?
Well, ang sasabihin ko sa kanila, wala tayo sa loob ng simbahan.
Hmm.
Pero yung mas natin, mas kisiyan, misa pa rin yan. Mm-hmm. You gracious, as long as you are disposed.
Mm-hmm.
So, yun lang ang sinasabi. Iba talaga. Inside the church.
Yes, pa.
Pero we tell them na control never receive the same graces as you dispose yourself to receive God's graces.
Mm-hmm. Kamusta naman po yung mga ibang activities po ninyo, Archbishop? Like for example, nung nagdaan po na Holy Week, kumusta po yung celebration?
Dito sa Kwanzaa, si mga tao dito, they are used to the traditional way Holy Week traditions. So traditions ngayon, like the procession, talagang mahalaga yan sa kanila, yung mass, stations of the cross, yun. Ilocanos in general are quite religious, the traditional way.
Archbishop, ano naman po yung mga advocacies and other activities nyo po na nakalatag dito po sa Archdiocese?
Oh, okay, so matagal ng program ng Archdiocese namin yung DEC.
Okay.
Pero ang tawag namin dito CISA. CISA or we have another name. But basically, it's basic ecclesial communities.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe have been assigned, and this has been the program since the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
So I think we are one of the pioneer local churches na nag-implement ng basic ecclesial communities, although it could take different forms.
Mm-hmm.
So yung DEC, hindi lang isa lang way, it's not just one way of doing DEC, but it could take different forms according to the situations of people.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But basically, yan ang ginagawa namin.
Mm-hmm.
And then of course, we have an active Caritas.
Ah.
Yung Caritas namin, you have Caritas Manila, Caritas Pampanga, we have Caritas Nueva Segovia. And it's doing a lot, really, in reaching out to needy people. We bring doctors to faraway places.
Mm-hmm.
We collect medicines. Those things. So we put some Caritas.
Mm-hmm. Archbishop, matanong ko lang po kayo sa lahat po ng mga activities and ginagawa niyo po sa mga different parishes po na sakop po ninyo. May free time pa po ba kayo? Nakakapag-relax pa po ba kayo? Or may mga hobbies or interest po ba kayo, Archbishop?
Oh, meron. Otherwise, wala na kami rito. Nasa hospital na kami. Okay, well basically, kung wala akong ganong schedule, I rest.
Mm-hmm.
I rest, I read, I travel short distances lang. Naman.
Mm-hmm.
So, yun lang naman. So, reading, resting, and a little travel with friends. Nothing fancy. Nothing.
Bishop, ano po yung motto po ninyo and bakit yun po yung napili po ninyo?
Yung motto ko ay Pax Hominibus.
Mm-hmm.
Ibig sabihin, peace to all. Peace to all. At ito ang what I'm trying na isabuhay.
Mm-hmm.
Na hanggat maaari, we reach out to people. We reach out to people and we extend peace to them.
Mm-hmm.
So, yun na. This is the only way, I think, to draw people to Christ.
Mm-hmm.
If you are welcoming,
mm-hmm.
if you make them feel welcome,
mm-hmm.
and if even if there are different that we try to in a, that will not make it worse. So peace to all, either in terms sa relationship sa mga kaparian, sa mga tao, sa mga officials, government officials, we take this, at least for me, I take this attitude na peace is the best thing that we can offer to people.
Mm-hmm.
Magbabalik ang Mama's Voice, Mama Mary's Voice, kaya huwag kayong aalis. We are still with Archbishop Peralta dito pa rin sa Arsobispado ng Nuya dito sa Vigan, Ilocos Sur. Like, share and subscribe natin ang episode na ito to spread the good news and good vibes.
Anong ibang ministries po ninyo dito po sa Archdiocese? Ano po? Kumusta po yung mga ministries nyo po, especially po siguro yung sa social communication po nung po yung attendance pag distancing, so medyo umangat po or nagtrabaho po talaga ng double time yung ating social communications.
Tama.
Kamusta po dito sa Archdiocese?
Yes, it's the same thing that the other dioceses, parishes were doing. During the pandemic, of course, we were just limited to online masses.
Mm-hmm.
And then there was a time na very limited lang, 5-10 lang pwedeng pumasok sa simbahan.
Yes po.
So, we tried to make do with that.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi wala tayong magawa.
Tapa.
So, doon lumitaw yung importance ng social media talaga.
Mm-hmm.
At saka Facebook. Mm-hmm. At saka Facebook. We tell our priests that use your Facebook accounts not only to post personal things,
yes,
kung pagkain, kung ano-ano dyan. Use your Facebook account also to evangelize.
Mm-hmm.
If you have many friends in your Facebook account, make use that to convey God's word. Hindi lang yung mga pagkain ng pinupost ninyo kung saan kayo napunta.
Kayo po ba, Archbishop, ay ano po ba, active po ba sa online or sa social media world po?
Ako, sa totoo lang, tungkol sa Facebook, I find it a little bit problematic for me.
Uh-huh.
Because, well, I have many things to do.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes I cannot answer all questions there. So, nakikibasa na lang ako.
Mm-hmm.
And then they inform me naman.
Mm-hmm.
They inform me. And then we have a group chat sa mga kaparian dito.
Mm-hmm.
We have a Facebook page ng Archdiocese. We make use of that.
Mm-hmm.
We make use of that. So, doon na lang ako, Juan, pumapasok.
Mm-hmm.
Pero yung personal Facebook account, wala na kasi, yun nga, ay I find it difficult to answer all questions doon.
Mm.
Yeah, but of course I get myself updated naman.
Yes. Archbishop, tanong ko lang po, ano, nung na-install po kayo as the bishop po sa Alaminas, Pangasinan, paano po yung process noon?
Yes, yes. If you go to any diocese or archdiocese, mm-hmm. may bagong installation.
Mm-hmm. Installation po ang tawag.
Yes, yeah. Pero hindi ordination. Kasi you only get ordained once as a bishop.
Mm-hmm.
But when you get to a new diocese, doon kailangan ang bagong installation.
Mm-hmm.
So tulad sa Alaminos, I was installed as the bishop of Alaminos. Dito sa Vigan, I was also installed as the Archbishop of Segovia way back in 2014.
Mm-hmm.
So, 9 years na. Matagal na rin.
Yes,
in 2 years, I'm retiring.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully.
Sino po ang nag-i-install po sa inyo noon, Archbishop?
Ah, usually the Archbishop of the place.
Uh-huh.
Dito sa akin, sino ba yung nag-i-install sa akin? Hindi ko naman
kung bishop po yung kung archbishop po yung mag-i-install sa bishop, sino naman po yung mag-i-install sa archbishop?
It's the same na, pareho na yan. When I got ordained as bishop, it was Cardinal Vidal who was the main consecrator plus two bishops.
Mm-hmm.
Pero if you get installed as a bishop, usually it's the archbishop of the place who installs you.
Mm-hmm.
Sa akin, hindi ko na kaya maalala. Sa taga na siguro.
Oo nga po. Anyway po, Archbishop, may special devotion po ba kayo to the Blessed Virgin?
Yes. Simple lang, I just tell the Blessed Mother, I am your son.
Mm-hmm.
Yun lang, just tell her that you are a child of hers, her God. You need her, especially when yun lang naman.
Mm-hmm.
And then, I also have a special devotion to Padre Pio. Padre Pio. Because when I was young, maybe 7, I remember, my uncle told me, why not write to Padre Pio and ask him to pray for you that you may become a priest. I did it. Mm-hmm. I wrote it.
Mm-hmm.
1-2 sentences.
Mm-hmm.
And my mother mailed it. Surprise of surprise, Padre Pio wrote back. And he said, I will pray that you will become a priest.
Wow!
So, naging pare ako. Hindi lang naging pare, naging obispo pa.
Oo nga po. Okay.
So, Padre Pio, talaga si Padre Pio, a lot of people, including myself, have felt the powerful intercession of Padre Pio. And of course, Blessed Mother.
Tanong ko lang po, Archbishop, nasa sa inyo po pa po ba yung letter na yun?
Yan, tinago ng mother ko. Matagal ko nang hinahanap since she died. Yung mga cabinet niya, siguro, hopefully, I can find it one day.
Pag nahanap po natin yun.
and put it in a frame.
Yes po.
Join us again next week on the next part of our interview. I would like to thank Simpao Makapagal Vision Center for my eyewear. We would like to thank the following.
There you have it, guys. Thank you for joining us in this episode of Mama's Voice. Hope to see you in our future episode. This has been your host, Karen Dame. Jamat Raishinen!